Hey everyone, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video. Today we are going to discuss a lot of interesting questions. So let's begin. But if you are a newcomer and you haven't subscribed to our channel, then do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell notification, because it is going to help you in getting updated about the new uploads on our channel. This is the Telegram group which you can join if you want to enjoy the free quizzes as well as the updates that we provide on our channel. The link of this Telegram group is in the description below. This is the new course for RBI Grade B 2022, guys. Here you will get PDFs, videos and mocks. Apart from this, you will also get interview training. So we conduct mock interviews so that you can be prepared for your final interviews of RBI Grade B. And this is the book kit, guys, that you will get if you enroll in this course. And this book kit contains all the books mentioned right in front of you. And right now we are running a 30% discount on this course. So if you want to avail that discount, you can use RBI 30 coupon code. And this is the number. The number is right in front of you. You can use that number if you have any queries related to the course or eligibility for the examination or about the examination. So we resolve every kind of query related to the exam at this number. Now let's discuss our first question. Which of the following institution developed world's first genetically modified rubber plant? So you have the five options: Rubber Technology Institute, Rubber Research and Development Institute, IIT Madras, Rubber Research Institute of India, Rubber Development Institute. So out of these options, the option D, that is Rubber Research Institute of India, which is based in Kerala, is the right answer. Now guys, this is the world's first genetically modified rubber plant. First of all, you should know that this first world's first genetically modified rubber plant, that is GM rubber plant, has been planted at the outskirts of Guwahati in Assam. So this is a very relevant information that can be asked from you in your examination as well. Now, the second point of importance is that why do we need to create this world's first genetically modified rubber plant? For that, you should know this thing, that rubber plants are grown in the humid region. And India is a region which is prone to droughts as well as winter. So we enjoy the cold season as well as we are very prone to the droughts. So this genetically modified rubber plant has a gene which is named as MNSOD. So this is the short form of manganese containing super dioxide dismutase. So this is the element, this is the gene that is present in this world's first genetically modified rubber plant. So what is the purpose of this gene? The purpose is to protect the plant cells from the cold as well as from the drought. So basically this is going to protect the plant cells and strengthen the plant so that it can survive the worst conditions like cold and drought. So this is going to revolutionize the India's natural rubber growing industry. Now that was all about this rubber plant, this genetically modified rubber plant. What was the need? What is the specialty that we have discussed? Now you should also know this fact, that this research institute is under the Rubber Board. And Rubber Board is a statutory body that was constituted under the Rubber Act 1947. Your task is to tell me the chairperson of this board. Who is that present, the chairperson of this rubber board? I hope that this question is clear to you, and if you have any query, you can ask me in the comment section below. Now, before moving on to the next question, I would like to tell you guys, particularly the NABARD students, remember this full form, guys. And also RBI and SEBI students are also required to memorize this full form of MNSOD, because this is the world's first genetically modified rubber plant. Therefore, there are high chances that the element, which is the modification, that can be asked from you in your examination. So do not forget to memorize this full form. Next question is very easy. Which state has become India's first rabies-free state? So Manipur, Tripura, Goa, Nagaland, Uttarakhand, out of which Goa is the right answer. So Goa has become India's first rabies-free state. There is nothing much that you can remember here, because it is just a one-line statement from the news. you can remember this much only. But I would like to ask a question from you. You have to tell me who is at present the governor of Goa. Which state has signed an MOU with the UK government to strengthen and support clean and green energy tech startups in the state? Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Odisha are in the options, out of which Maharashtra is the right answer. Now guys, this MOU has been signed in order to strengthen and support the clean and green energy tech startups in the state. I hope there is nothing much that you cannot understand here, because this is a very simple state purpose that has been stated in the question itself. Now this MOU has been signed under a program that was already in place between Maharashtra and UK government. What is that program? The program is Act for Green. Now, under this program, both UK government and the Maharashtra state government provide support to the tech startups that are in the field of clean and green energy. And how are they going to provide the support? They open their market access for these startups. For example, if the UK-based startup, particularly in the field of green energy, is willing to work in the Maharashtra state, then the compliance burden or related formalities would be lessened for those companies in comparison to other foreign companies which are going to register under this Act for Green program. So I hope that this much is clear to you guys, and apart from this, you don't have to memorize anything related to this news. Okay, so here comes our next question. Which bank has launched Arogyam Loan Business Loan Scheme for healthcare sector to extend loan support in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic? HDFC, State Bank of India, Canara Bank, Axis Bank, ICICI Bank. So the right answer is State Bank of India. Now guys, under this Arogyam Loan, the healthcare facilities or the institutions will get loan. And what is the purpose? The purpose is either to modernize the existing facility or to expand the facility. So that is the purpose for which they can avail the loan under this Arogyam scheme. Under this scheme, rupees 100 crores is the maximum limit to which the businesses or the hospitals can avail the loan. And this loan is to be repaid in the tenure of 10 years. So that is another fact that you should memorize. Now apart from this, you should also know this fact that for different kinds of cities, for example, for tier 1 cities or urban centers, the limit for the loan that a business can avail is rupees 20 crore. So it starts from that, and the maximum limit is rupees 100 crore. So here you don't have to memorize it tier wise or city wise. You have to memorize the exact limit, the maximum limit of loan that is being provided under this Arogyam scheme, that is rupees 100 crores. Now on that note guys, can you tell me when was this SBI became a nationalized bank? I am asking you the act under which State Bank of India was established. So this is your task. Tell me in the comment section below. Who heads the panel formed by International Financial Services Centres Authority to examine global best practices in ship financing and leasing, identify opportunities and prepare a roadmap to enable such activities from GIFT IFSC? Om Prakash Uttank Joshi, Vandana Agarwal, P. Dangarajan, Vidisha Sen Gupta. The right answer is option C. Vandana Agarwal has been appointed as the chairperson of this panel, and the purpose of this panel is to identify the best practices in ship leasing and financing business so that that business can be provided space in the GIFT IFSC, which is located in Gandhinagar in Gujarat. Now guys, you should also know this fact. Who is the chairperson of this International Financial Services Centers Authority? It is Injethi Srinivasan. Guys, if you remember that there was a committee that was formed by IFSCA in order to promote the retail business in the GIFT IFSC, your task is to tell me the chairperson of that committee that was formed by this authority to promote the retail business in the IFSC in the comment section below. Thank you so much guys for watching this video till the end, and I hope that you have learned something during the video. Thank you so much.